phi the inverse Laplace transform of phi s over s minus 2 squared. First, looking at this, I cannot find the inverse Laplace transform of this directly. So, after a while thinking about this, I see that it would be right if I have s minus 2 on top, because I can simplify this down. So, how to make that? So, well, just put it in, just make it. Just make what we need. Okay? So, we need s minus 2 on top, so we'll just make it, right? And then we have to fix it, of course. So initially, it just has phi s, but after I have I subtract 2, then distribute this, I have phi s minus 10. Well, I need to add 10 to compensate this. Right? Now I'm going to split this out. So I have L inverse of phi times s minus 2 over s minus 2 squared, which gives me phi over s minus 2, plus L inverse of 10 over s minus 2 squared. Okay? Now, the inverse of this is going to be phi times e to the 2t, right? What about this one? Let me factor out 10 first. And then the L inverse of this, 1 over s minus 2 squared. So ignore the minus 2 here. So what does it look like? It looks like 1 over s squared and L inverse of 1 over s squared is just t, right? But since we have a shift here, so we need to have e to the 2t times t, okay? So you have... If you're not sure, you can take the Laplace transform of this and this, then it should give you this. So the Laplace transform of this is phi times 1 over s minus 2. But this one, ignore this first. The Laplace transform of this is 1 over s squared. And since you have the shift here, so you have the minus 2 in parentheses. For this one, you use the translation on the s-axis theorem. Okay? So that is your final solution. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.